If you'd like to create an SMS as part of a workflow rule, first set up a workflow rule as you normally would with an appropriate trigger and appropriate conditions. You might only do it if the lead source is, say, trade show. Next, choose under instant actions, create record. We're going to choose smooth messages. In the name, you could put something like welcome SMS before and press the hash to be able to use merge fields. Under the owner, you'll generally want to use the lead owner, for example, but you could also hard code it to be a certain user. Click the plus sign, and next, the key thing you'll want to choose is, see how here I'm using the drop down in order to choose the appropriate field. I'm going to choose lead name. We're going to choose current record, and then we're going to put in the message. And we can write anything we want. That's actually all we need to do. By setting the lead name and the message, our code will automatically find any phone numbers associated with that lead and send the message to those numbers. If you want to be a little bit more precise, you can specify a to number. You can put in, for example, the mobile number. And if you wanted to make sure that it would only send to that number and none others, for example, if you're in the UK and you're concerned about accidentally sending a voice message to someone's landline, what you can do is specify here that you only want the specified to field to be used. If you don't tick this, then what will happen is that if the mobile field is blank, then it will go and check out other fields. For example, if you had a phone field, it might use that instead. Just want to reinforce at this point that everything that I'm showing you apart from lead name and message is optional. If you want to be quite fast, then just specify the owner, lead name and message, and our system will figure out the rest. But there are some other fields that you can add in. You can, for example, specify which from number to send from. You could, for this part, you just literally type in a number and it will try and use that if you have it as a valid sender ID. The other things you can do, you can specify if you want to send a image with the message, you can include a link to a image that you want to include. Another property that you might want to set is the message reporting tag. This can help with when you send out a bunch of messages, if you want to see which of your workflow messages are being replied to the most, you can specify a certain reporting tag. And then later when you use a CRM report to look at who is replying to your messages, you'll be able to use that as a filter. The two remaining features that you want to use potentially, but be very careful about them, are skip duplicate check and skip reschedule check. Most of the time you will not want to use these, but in some cases, if you would like to send the same message to someone multiple times, generally not a good idea, because you could end up spamming them. If you have misconfigured your workflow rule, you may send out potentially hundreds of duplicate messages to the same person. Probably not a good idea, but if you did need to have duplicate messages going out, probably the only time that you would want to use this is during testing. If you are sending a message to yourself and you're making duplicate leads, our system will actually block the message if you use the same phone number and you're sending the same message to that number. But if you wanted to avoid that purely during testing, you can tick skip duplicate check. The other skip option we have is skip reschedule check. By default, we will reschedule workflow SMS that are triggered outside your defined sending hours, which are normally 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Most people don't really like getting SMS out of that time period unless it's truly critical. So I would recommend generally not ticking this box. If you do tick it, then it's going to send the SMS at the time that the workflow rule is triggered, which could be at 3 a.m. if something goes wrong with your system. So if you do decide, it might be that you've got an SMS going out as soon as someone fills out a form on your website, and maybe some people do legitimately fill it out at 3 a.m. That, and by the way, just to clarify, with the reschedule check, it's based on the recipient's time zone. So for example, if I fill it out and I use an Australian number and it's actually not 3 a.m. for me, even though it might be 3 a.m. in the US, we would still send it out if it was, say, 5 p.m. my time. But if it was 3 a.m. in the US, then if you don't tick this box, then it is not going to send it out at the time. It will reschedule it for the following day. Most of the time, keep this blank. Two other use cases are if you are wanting to send an SMS to the participants in a meeting or the person that you had a call with, you can set activity type and activity ID. And here you would put in the ID of the meeting. All of that's a lot of information. Going back to the basic workflow rule, all you need to set is either the lead name, the contact name, deal name, and the message. And then if you want to add in any of these advanced features, you can, but it's not required. The other thing you can do, you can have a scheduled workflow SMS that might happen 2 hours, 2 days, you name it, it will send out an SMS at that time if you do exactly the same thing. No difference in the step here, it's exactly the same as what I showed you under instant actions. And one thing to call out here is that these scheduled actions will only be triggered if the conditions remain true. For example, if I actually went in and I changed the lead source an hour after the lead was created, this second scheduled action, which was, let's say I did actually put in a SMS there, scheduled 2 hours after the rule trigger time, that wouldn't be set because the condition is no longer true. With this combination of features, you can create quite powerful workflow SMS capabilities. You can even mix it up so that maybe you would send an SMS immediately and then you might send an email 2 hours later, or the other way around, and then a day later send another SMS. You can have quite detailed ways to communicate with your customers and leads by using a combination of SMS and email.